me? Can you find that? What did it say? Oh my God, it's hilarious. Yeah,
so it's a lively 7-hour interview with Joe Rogan. Imagine.
Yeah. Yeah.
Imagine how many votes he would win if he did that. Well, I bet a lot. I bet he'd lose a lot too.
Yeah.
He'd be like, what is happening? You need some more of that? I'll have to.
I don't know.
Want some more coffee?
There might be a little bit.
We can get some more.
Okay.
Put the order in. Yeah, that guy, he's not taking anything but perhaps a few uppers to help with speeches. You see with the Biden thing, he Trump said he wanted to do a drug test before debates.
Really?
Yeah.
No. What does he think Biden's on?
Oh, they got him hopped up on something.
Really?
Yeah, if you're that tired.
Yeah.
I guarantee you they're doing something with him.
Him talking, oh my God, it's painful. I mean, it's like I feel embarrassed.
Yeah, it's sad. Yeah. It's sad, and then there's the tremendous pressure that's involved in that job.
Yeah, I couldn't imagine.
No.
I mean, not being at your best.
No,
that's what I've always. I mean, I've always been. I just don't get how there's these people who've been in politics for 50 years, and I'm like, okay, good job, thank you, you did it, you served whoever. But isn't there somebody better? I mean, smarter, younger, like more energized? Why do we have these 80-year-old guys?
I don't know. It doesn't make any sense.
I mean, there's got to be people who are just like on the top of their game. You can't be at the top of your game when you're 80.
Yeah, you got to wonder like what it is with the powers that be that decided to go with him. Did they think that he's a known name? A former vice president, so that brings him to. But there was obviously some shenanigans because they were really worried about Bernie Sanders taking the nomination. They were really worried that he was going to enact some radical change to the Democratic Party, and they were not looking forward to that at all. So,
you know,
they stepped in, got Mayor Pete and Amy Klobuchar and all those other people to back out, to back down, and then all the delegates went to Biden, and then Biden winds up being the guy, and. You almost feel bad for the guy.
Yeah, I mean, that can't be our best option for running. I mean, so whoever wins, you want to feel confident.
Yeah.
You know? And I know people on the other side of where I am don't feel confident in
Trump. I
think
they're banking on Harris. They're banking on people saying, well, she's young and healthy. She'll take over.
She is young. I mean, so it goes to that point of being young and, you know, energetic. But, she's kept a lot of people in jail.
Yeah.
I don't know. Man, politics, what a mess.
It's gross. It's gross. And I don't know what the best way to do it is. You know, I think our founding fathers had some pretty brilliant ideas.
How were they so dialed in so long ago?
It's amazing.
To note, they write this constitution not to protect the government from the people, from the government from overstepping. How did they know? I mean, maybe because it was the king and queen. And
yeah, I think they saw people had an understanding of psychology back then, of just human beings and just the natural tendency of people to abuse power and to abuse influence. And I think they just came out with a really brilliant way to sort of have checks and balances to keep that from getting completely out of hand.
Yeah.
It's amazing. It really is amazing if you stop and think about that, you know.
And how old... There's this young man, Madison Cawthorn. He has, I think he's like I can't remember what seat he won, but one of the youngest ever win an election. I think it's in North Carolina. But he mentioned something about the age of,
Jefferson?
Yeah, like how old were they?
People didn't live that long.
I know,
then. They got like toothaches and died.
Right. Were they in their 20s?
I wonder. Let's Google. How old was Thomas Jefferson when he drafted the Declaration of Independence? How old do you think he is?
And it's close to 40, I believe.
Close to 40. Still pretty amazing.
Yeah. Or maybe,
you know?
Maybe.
What if you go back and you actually look at him and he looks exactly like Jared Kushner? Wait. 30,
everybody does.
It's him.
Hold on a second. In age in 1776, Thomas Jefferson was 33.
Wow.
So young.
And fucking smart as shit.
Yeah. I mean, I think some of those guys were in their 20s.
40, 53.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Yeah.